Sensing the bear hot on his tail, he turned and pointed the other snowshoe like a sword ready to throw. "Don't make me use the other one," he warned. The bear grunted, shuffling back and forth warily. "Go on, get!" Alabaster waved the end of the snowshoe in the animal's direction. The bear snorted as it considered its next move. "I said get!" Alabaster bellowed, holding on to Fluffy with everything he had. Finally, the bear turned its head and skulked away, apparently deciding that confronting an angry elf waving a snowshoe was far less appealing than going back to sleep. Once it had retreated to the mouth of its cave, Alabaster lowered the snowshoe and reattached it to the sole of his foot. He lifted the flap of his satchel and gently placed the creature inside, muttering under his breath all the while, "You're going to get me into a world of trouble." Chapter 5. Reindeer Milk. "I hope you like reindeer milk," Alabaster called from the kitchen, stirring a bubbling saucepan over the stove. "I don't know what else to offer you. Anyway, a nice cup of reindeer milk is the perfect thing for a good night's sleep." The creature, nestled snugly on a cushion in the living room, sniffed the sweet air approvingly. Alabaster carefully measured out the milk from the saucepan, one half into a Christmas mug, the other half into a cereal bowl, and carried both on a tray. He deposited the tray on the sofa beside his new guest. "I only have one cup, so I've had to put yours in a bowl, I'm afraid," Alabaster said with a chuckle. He'd never entertained like this before. "I hope that's okay with you." The animal didn't seem to mind at all, lapping hungrily at the bowl's steaming contents with a long pink tongue. All the while, Alabaster continued to chatter incessantly, telling his new guest everything there was to know in exchange for an occasional confused blink of the creature's huge black eyes.